It was sent out for all of mankind. This Quran is for everyone. Whatever language you speak, the Quran is for you. Why did the Quran choose Arabic if not everybody is Arab? Because the best language is the Arabic language. It is the what? It's the best language. Also, the Quran, it points out, it explains to you, it tells you what every benefit that you need in this world or the hereafter, the Quran has told you about it. It has conveyed everything for you. The Quran is what we recite with our tongues. It is what is written in our masahif, in our mushafs. It is also what's memorized in the people's chest. That's all the Quran. This Quran, no falsehood can come to it. Anyone who tries to tamper with it, he won't succeed. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَى وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. We send down the Quran, and we're the ones that are going to look after it. So no one is able to tamper with the Quran. Even if they do, they don't get far with it. A young kid is going to come and read the ayah fully. And he's going to correct him and say, this is not what it is. Na'am.
وَأَمَّا السُّنَّةِ فَإِنَّهَا أَقْوَالُ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ وأفعاله وتقريراته على الأقوال والأفعال.
The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Sunnah is what? The Sunnah is the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. His speeches. What he said is a Sunnah. The Sunnah is what? فإنها أقوال النبي, the Prophet's speeches, the things that he said, عليه الصلاة والسلام. وأفعاله, his actions. The Prophet's actions is what? Anything he did. Now pay attention, brothers. Actions are also his turuq. Pay attention to that. You have to add into the word af'alu, his turuq. Things that he left are actions as well. Huh? Aren't the things that you leave actions? They are actions. ولذلك the sahabas, what did they say? When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the day of the trench, the battle of Ahzab, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was digging the hole, this is what the Sahabas, they said, لَوْ جَلَسْنَا وَالنَّبِيُّ يَعْمَلُ فَذَاكَ مِنَّا عَمَلُ الْمُضَلِّلُ. If we sit down whilst the Prophet is working, then that is an action of misguidance. But they're not doing anything, they're just sitting back. So they refer to them sitting back, not doing anything. Not doing anything, just sitting back. And not doing anything, they refer to it as what? They refer to it as an action. Also, the Sahabas, they took from the Prophet, if he left something, he didn't do it, and they saw that he didn't do it, they knew it was from the Sunnah that they have to follow him in it. They knew that it felt under وَأَفْعَالُهُ, his actions. What's the evidence for that? When the lizard was brought to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and the Sahabas all went to eat it, some of them went to eat it, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he chose not to eat it. So the Sahabas, they looked at the Prophet and they said, Ya Rasulullah, aharamun hiya, is it haram? Is the lizard haram? Are we not allowed to eat it? Why did they say, is it haram? Because the Prophet didn't eat it. So they knew they had to follow him in whatever he left behind. Then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no, it's just my people don't eat it. Meaning we're not used to this, our culture is not this. So the Prophet pushed it away. Alayhi salatu wa salam. Also Allah referred to the action of people leaving something behind, Allah referred to it, or them not doing anything, Allah referred to it as an action. He said, لُعِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ عَلَى لِسَانِ دَاوُودَ وَعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمْ ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْا وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ كَانُوا لَا يَتَنَاهَوْنَ عَنْ مُنْكَرٍ فَعَلُوهُ لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. Allah said, the curse are upon who? لُعِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ عَلَى لِسَانِ دَاوُودَ وَعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمْ ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْا وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ. They disobeyed Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, they went against his command. Are you with me? وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ, and they transgressed, they exceed their limits. Allah then says, كَانُوا لَا يَتَنَاهَوْنَ عَمْ مُنْكَرٍ فَعَلُوا. كَانُوا لَا يَتَنَاهَوْنَ عَمْ مُنْكَرٍ فَعَلُوا. They would not stop one another from a what? An evil. If they saw each other do something evil, they wouldn't stop each other from it. They'll just kick back. And they'll just watch each other. Allah then says, لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا, what an evil thing that they did. The ayah may be, I might be reading it wrong, the ayah may not be لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ, it may be لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ. I'm confused, but I think it's لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. It's لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. Because the ayah is Surah Al-Nahl, where Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He says, when He speaks about there's a village which is a village where Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He talks about مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ لَا لَا Allah ayah says, where Allah talks about a what's the beginning of the ayah where Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He says, He's talking about Mecca, that يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا رَغَدًا مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ فَكَفَرَتْ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ فَأَذَاقَهَا اللَّهُ لِبَاسَ الْجُوعِ وَالْخَوْفِ بِمَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ. That ayah, the ending, لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ, that's the ayah I always get it wrong with. So it's either لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ, you sure? Ha. Based on the ayah, it becomes what? Proof to say that, it becomes a proof to say that whatever a people do, not do, whatever they don't do, they sit back, it's an action. So do we follow the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in that? We follow him alayhi salatu wa sallam in that. There are a lot of evidences that the Quran and the Sunnah prove that we have to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his Sunnah. قُلْ أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَإِنْ تَوَلُّوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْكَافِرِينَ. Also Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala says, فَلْيَحْذَرِ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِهِ أَنْ تُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةً أَوْ يُصِيبَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. Also Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala says, فَإِنْ تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. Also Allah says, وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَالرَّسُولُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ. Allah also said, إِنَّمَا كَانَ قَوْلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ أَنْ يَقُولُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. There are many evidences that all point out following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as sunnah. So anyone who says to you, I'm a Qur'aniyun, he's a liar. You're not a Qur'ani, because the Qur'an tells you to follow the Prophet. If you're sticking to the Qur'an only, the Qur'an told you, قُلْ أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ, obey Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, وَالرَّسُولَ and the Messenger. So how can you follow the Qur'an and not follow the sunnah, how can you follow the Qur'an when the Qur'an is clearly telling you what? To follow the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So based on that brothers, the sunnah is what? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's speech, anything which he says. So a hadith, when you hear that, it says, qala rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you answer. Or, kana rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaf'alu, ama fa'ala rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet used to do this, or he used to do this, na'am. Those are fa'ala. The next one is called وَتَقْرِرَاتُهُ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the things that were done in front of him and that he consented to. His consent are what? His consent are evidence. Like when Jabir said, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, كُنَّا نَعْزِلُ وَالْقُرْآنُ يَنْزِلُ. We used to do quarters interruption, and when the Qur'an would come down, we used to do that. So the Qur'an didn't stop us from it. So this is what? That it means the consent of the Prophet's silence. Now some people may say, maybe the Prophet didn't know that they were doing this. But then doesn't Allah know, subhanahu wa ta'ala? Doesn't Allah tabarak wa ta'ala not know? Allah knows. Allah would have brought a ruling regarding this matter. So now the sheikh, he's going to move on to, as I said, the dalalat. How to extract evidences from the kitab and the sunnah. Now pay attention. Some people will say to you, I want just kitab and sunnah. And how are you going to get it from the kitab and sunnah? The Kitab and the Sunnah, the way to extract rulings from it, they change. Na'am. So now we're going to see it. Faddal.
فالأحكام الشرعية.
Now the jurisprudent rulings, how to extract from the Kitab and Sunnah. The Sheikh is going to tell us, a handful of them.
تارة تؤخذ من نص الكتاب والسنة. وهو اللفظ الواضح الذي لا يحتمل إلا ذلك المعنى.
Sometimes the way we take it from the Kitab and the Sunnah is by way of nas. Underline the word nas. Sometimes we take it from the Kitab and the Sunnah by way of what? By way of nas. What does nas mean? The Sheikh told it to you. So sometimes we take it from the Kitab and the Sunnah by way of nas. So some of the ulama will say to you, this mas'ala nas. Ama? This is a nassun fil mas'ala. When they say nass to you, what does it mean? Sheikh told you, al-lafzul wadihu alladhi la yahtamilu illa dhalika al-ma'na. It is a lafz. Lafz means what? The word lafz, what enters it is hadithun nafs, where the person talks to himself, is a lafz. And whatever the person says is a lafz. The utterance of anything, it's a lafz. Also, ishara, pointing towards something, is a lafz. And anything that takes those two meanings. Al-wadih means what? Clear. Which is, al-wadih means what? The clear cut. What did I say lafz meant? What did I say lafz meant? Sorry, lafz is anything that isn't whispers of yourself and not ishara. Lafz has to be utterance, sorry. Are you with me? The lafz is, it's not a whisper of your heart. Whatever you whisper to yourself is not called a lafz. And a ishara is not called a lafz. It's not called a lafz. Al-wadih, clear means what? Ay as-sarih. It's direct, it's clear. Naam. Very good. The third one is what? Alladhi la yahtamilu illa dhalika al-ma'na. All of that is what? It doesn't carry any other meaning. So what drops out from there? Al-dhahir and al-mujmal. They're not in here. Because both of them, they can carry more than one meaning. And we're going to take what zahir and mujmal means. It's going to come to us. Pay attention. So nas is basically, it's a lafz utterance, which is clear, which doesn't carry any other meaning. 100% it means this, nothing else. An example for that means is what? An example is the adad, numbers. Numbers are nas. Are you with me? A number is a nas. What does that mean? When Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He said in the Quran, Tilka asharatun kamila. And that is 10, which is full. In Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 196. Hada nas. It doesn't take any other meaning. No other meaning whatsoever. This type, which is a nas, it is obligatory that the person sticks to that one and he implements it. And you're not allowed to divert to any. You're not allowed to divert to anything else. No other text can you give precedence over a text which is nas, except which one, unless it's abrogated. If it gets abrogated, then of course you leave it, for the one that abrogates it, or unless there comes an evidence which diverts it from its apparent meaning, it diverts it. A diversion comes, which is a sarif comes. Other than that, you stick to it because it's a nas. Naam.
وتارة تؤخذ من ظاهرهما.
And sometimes you take it from its apparent meaning. So what does ظاهر mean? Sheikh is going to tell us.
وهو ما دل على ذلك على وجه العموم اللفظي أو المعنوي.
ظاهر means. So the second, you underline the first one نص, right? Now you're underlining نص. ظاهر, sorry. ظاهر means what? ظاهر is the apparent. The Sheikh explained it to you. It is وهو. This huwa goes back to what? Al-lafz, lafz. Wa huwa al-lafz. It's a lafz. Al-wa, the lafz which is wadih, it's clear. So what does it share with nas? Both of them are lafz. Both of them are wadih. Good. Ma dalla ala dhalika ala ahsa. Ma dalla ala dhalika ala wajh al-umum. It indicates, what is it indicating? The hukum shar'i we're talking about. We're talking about the hukum shar'i. Dalla, at the beginning we were talking about, what was the heading? فالأحكام الشرعية. So, it indicates this ruling, this jurisprudent ruling, it shows it, على وجه العموم, in a general manner. ما معنى in a general manner? Either by wording or by meaning. What does it mean by general wording or meaning? It means what comes to the mind first. Al-mutabadiru ila al-dhihn. When you read this, what's the first thing that comes to your mind first? The apparent means the thing that first comes to your mind when the utterance is taken. But pay attention. But there is an opposite side. It only shows this meaning 70, 60, 80%. That meaning it shows it. So, if something shows you, are you with me? If it shows you the meaning, 70% it has this meaning in it. That's what comes to the mind first. That's why the percentage is high and it's closer that way. This is called what? This is called a zahir. This is what? A zahir. But there is a possibility that it can take another meaning. But that other possibility is very little. The apparent is what? 80%. There is a 30, 40%. There's a 20% even. That it could take this other meaning. Are you guys with me? Ha. Let me look at one thing. What is the opposite? What is that 20 or 30%? What's it called, that 30% or that 20%? We said the 80% or the 70% or the 60% is called what? Zahir, right? The 20 or the 30% is what? Ta'wil. Mu'awwal. That's what mu'awwal is. Ta'wil is you're going from the, you're taking the lesser, the one that has the lesser percentage over the one that has the highest percentage. Are you with me? Now how is a something that you have 70% that it shows this and you're taking a 30%? Ta'wil, that's what it means according to the usuliyin. Are you guys with me? So, pay attention. Which one is the rajih? Zahir. Which one is marjuh? Which one is the lesser one? The ta'wil, the mu'awwal. Very good. Now, sorry, before you go in. What is the ruling regarding it? Or my example for it, sorry. An example and a ruling. An example is, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, tawadda min luhum al-ibil. Tawadda, he said, the Prophet ﷺ said, tawadda, do ablution from what? The meat of the? Do ablution for what? The camel meat. This hadith narrated by Imam Muslim. That which comes to the mind, straight away, that the word wudu means what? Washing the specific places of the body in which the sharia has set. You all know how to do wudu. So that hadith clearly, when somebody says to you that the Prophet said, tawadda min luhum min ibil, you will say to yourself, yes, this person, yes, so we do wudu from it, the way. But there's a weak, there is another meaning that could be in it, which is that the word wudu originally means nadafa, so it can mean to do usul, to have a bath. Now that is not zahir, that's not what comes to mind straight away. It is not al-mutabadiru ila dhihni. This is called the marjuh. It is called what? Marjuh. What's the ruling regarding it? The ruling regarding it is that we implement it. That we what? We implement it. And it's wajib to implement it. Na'am. Unless there comes an evidence that diverts it from it. Imam al-Shawkani, he brought an ijma in his book, Irshad al-Fuhul, page 176, that the zahir has to be implemented. And he brought an ijma from the Sahabas. You see? Because the path of the Salaf of this Ummah is that we implement it and that we stick to the zahir. Unless there comes a what? Unless there comes a evidence that shows it, that is what? That we take it away from its apparent meaning. Naam.
وتارة تؤخذ من المنطوق وهو ما دل على الحكم في محل النطق.
The next one is, the third one, is it's that which shows. Now sometimes we take the hukum shar'i. How do we take it? In terms of mantuq. Mantuq means utterance again. It is by way of utterance. The sharia clearly said it. Are you guys with me? And the sheikh explained it to you. It is, he said, huwa ma dalla ala al-hukmi. It is the thing that shows you the ruling fi mahall an-nutqi, by way of utterance. The sharia clearly tells you by what utterance. You take it directly from what was said. Like Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in the ayah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said in the ayah, fala taqul lahuma uffin, do not say uff to your mother. Are you with me? So this lafz, which is uff, you're not allowed to do ta'fif to your mother. You can't say uff, uff, uff to your mother, to your parents. Are you with me? نعم.
وتارة تؤخذ من المفهوم.
And sometimes it's taken from the. It is taken from the مفهوم. It is taken from the مفهوم. مفهوم is not the utterance. You've taken it by understanding it from the text. The text didn't say this to you, but you've understood it from the text. Now this is one the sheikh is going to give us. The types they come in. They come in two types. The sheikh is going to mention them. Inshallah ta'ala.
وهو ما دل على الحكم بمفهوم وموافقة إن كان.
Underline مفهوم الموافقة. That's the first type.
إن كان مساوية للمنطوق.
إن كان مساويا.
إن كان مساويا للمنطوق أو أولى منه. أو بمفهوم المخالفة.
Underline مفهوم المخالفة. The second one.
إذا خالف المنطوق في حكمه الكون
لكوني
في حكمه لكون المنطوق
وصف
بوصف أو شرط فيه شرط إذا تخلف ذلك الوصف أو الشرط تخلف الحكم.
The Sheikh رحمه الله تعالى now he tells us that sometimes it's taken out of it by way of مفهوم. By way of mafhum. Mafhum is it's the opposite to mantuq. Mantuq is what you take from it directly. If I tell you, listen, I'll give you an example. If I tell you, Abu Bakr, stand up. Now the mantuq is what? The mantuq is stand up. That's the mantuq. I've said to him, stand up. The mafhum is the opposite. It is what you've understood from it, which is what? Don't sit. Don't sit is what? It's a mafhum. You've understood that from my word. I didn't say don't sit. I just said stand up. Are you with me? Na'am. So mafhum, this is what it means. But the mafhum is two types. Mafhum al-muwafaqa and mafhum al-mukhalafa. So I'll explain that and then I'll explain word for word what the sheikh said. Mafhum al-muwafaqa means what? Mafhum al-muwafaqa. Mafhum al-muwafaqa, it is the meaning is benefited from the word by way of silence of it. It goes in agreement with the utterance. But the Sharia but it's not said, because it has to be understood from it. Sometimes the scholars, they call this lahnul khitab. The word mafhumul muwafaqa is called what? Lahnul khitab. It is called what? It is called lahnul khitab. That's when it's what? That is blacking if it is. It's called lahnul khitab. Pay attention. If the mafhumul muwafaqa is equal to the utterance. Please understand this is important. But inshallah, because it's usul al-fiqh, it requires what? Examples. Now I'll give you guys an example. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, take this ayah inshallah ta'ala. It's called lahnul khitab as well. To make it more easier for you guys. Instead of saying mafhumul muwafaqati musawiyan. Instead of saying that, just say lahnul khitab. And what does that mean? It means that this understanding is in agreement and it's proportional to the utterance that was made. It's proportional. For example, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nisa ayah 10. Allah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَأْكُلُونَ أَمْوَالَ الْيَتَامَ ظُلْمًا. Those who are eating the wealth, are you guys with me? Of the orphans by way of oppression. إِنَّمَا يَأْكُلُونَ They are eating with what? فِي بُطُونِهِمْ They are placing in their stomachs نَارًا hellfire. وَسَيَصْلَوْنَ سَعِيرًا And they will be punished by سَعِيرًا hellfire. Are you guys with me? So what has the ayah prevented me from? The ayah has prevented me from what? From eating the wealth of the children, the orphans, eating their wealth, huh? By way of oppression. Are you with me? Okay. That's the mantuq of the ayah. What about if I burn their wealth? If I burn it, I'm not going to eat it, I'll just burn it. I'll take all their money, put it somewhere and burn it. This is understood. And it's equal to eating it. Whether you eat it or you burn it, they're both the same. It's destroying the wealth. Isn't that it? That is called مفهوم موافقة مساوية للمنطوق. what was said in the ayah, what I understood from it is in agreement with it. Good, mashallah. There's another type of mafumul muwafaqah. Mafumul, that one was called what? That was called lahnul khitab. That was called what? That is called what? It's called lahnul khitab. The second type of mafumul muwafaqah is what called? It's called fahwul khitab. Or it's also called which the author said it. The author, he used a different wording, but fahwul khitab is also what the other scholars will call it, which is mafumu muwafaqa haya awla min al mantuqi, which is this type. Okay, pay attention. It is the understanding which is in agreement with the utterance, but is more befitting than it. And it's the one Allah Tabaraka Ta'ala, he said in the ayah, فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ. Don't say uff to your mother. What about if I beat my mother up? Can I beat her up? Because uff, if it said, أَوْلَى مِنْ. Uff is more little than beating her up. If uff was said no to, then of course you can't beat your mom up. Does that make sense? So this is called fahwa al-khitab. How did we get that from the ayah? We will say that the mantuq, which is uff, and the mafhum, which is ad-darb, hitting, which one is awla, which is more befitting? Darb is more befitting. Hitting is more befitting, because if you're told you can't even say uff to her, which is smaller, little, then of course hitting her is even greater. This is called fahwa al-khitab. We finished the first type of mafhum al-muwafaqah. We're now going to move on to the second type, which is called mafhum al-mukhalafa. The sheikh mentions all of this, and I'll explain it word for word, inshallah ta'ala, when I finish the explanation of it. The second is called mafhum al-mukhalafa. Mafhum al-mukhalafa, what is it? Mafhum al-mukhalafa is whatever the text said, your understanding is not in agreement, because that was the first type. The first one is called understanding which is in agreement to the text. Here, your understanding is reversed to the text. Your understanding the opposite to the text. With example, everything becomes clear. Good. And the sheikh brought, and how many types? He brought sifa, shart. He brought those two, I'm sure. What else did he bring? Huh? He mentioned bi wasfin or shartin. It's a wasp or shart. Underline those two. Those are the two types of mafhum al-mukhalafa. It is wasf or shart. What does that mean? It either comes by way of description or it comes by way of what? Condition. So what is that? What is this one called? Mafhum al-mukhalafa, what is it called? It's called dalil al-khitab. What is it called? Mafhum al-mukhalafa, sometimes the nuhat, what do they call it? Sorry, not the nuhat, usuliyin. What do they call it? They call it dalilul khitab. An example of the characteristic type, which is the one that's sifa, the sheikh mentions them in his matan. The sifa one is what? It is like when Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu in ja'akum fasiqum binaba'in fatabayyanu. Oh, another qira'a says what? فَتَثَبَّتُوا فَتَبَيَّنُوا أَوْ فَتَثَبَّتُوا. They're both two قِرَاءَتَانِ سَبْعِيَتَانِ. Good. This ayah is saying to me, all those of you who believe, if he comes to you, a person who is a fasiq, verify what he says to you. The reverse that I understand from this characteristic, because is this not an attribute to be a fasiq? It's a sifah. Very good. So this is called, and I'm going to do to it what? I'm going to come with a sifa, which is mukhalif. It's in opposition to what the ayah says, but it's a correct understanding, which is called mafhumul mukhalafa. What does that mean? It means, if the ayah says that if a fasiq comes to you, verify. So the ayah is saying to you, if he's not a fasiq, you don't have to verify. If a Muslim person, I don't know him upon fisq, I don't need to verify what he says, I can take it. Because the ayah said it to me. You're going to say to me, where in the ayah? I'll say to you, I took it from the ayah by way of mafhumul mukhalafa of this sifa. That the ayah says, إِن جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَيْنِ Fasiq, but he's not a fasiq, he's a sadiq. So fatabayyanu is not needed, or fatatabatu is not needed. I don't need to verify his reliability, I'll take on board. It's called the mafhum of the ayah. And that is called what? Dalilu da abdul khitab. The second type is called what? Mafhum al-shart, a condition. It's a condition. It's a condition. It's a shart. An example for that is ayah Surah Al-Talaq, ayah 6, where Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, he said, وَإِن كُنَّ أُولَاتَ حَمْلٍ If the woman you've divorced, the woman which you've divorced, she's a mutalaqa, you divorced her and she's what? She's pregnant. Allah says, this is a shart, it's a condition, right? Because Allah said, إِن if كُنَّ أُولَاتَ حَمْلٍ وَإِن if condition, she is pregnant. She's got a child in her stomach. Allah then says, فَأَنْفِقُوا عَلَيْهِنَّ Provide for the woman. حَتَّى يَضَعْنَ حَمْلَهُنَّ Until she gives birth to the child. For if you divorce her the day she becomes pregnant, for 9 months you have to give money to her. While she has that baby inside her. The مفهوم المخالفة, which is a shart, is that if she's not pregnant, I don't have to give her nothing. So the مخالفة is what? إن كانت غير حامل, if she's not pregnant, لا يجب الإنفاق عليها. I don't have to give her nothing. I don't have to. So those are the two types the Shaykh mentioned, which is called مفهوم المخالفة, which is a sifa, and a مفهوم المخالفة, which is a شرطة. It is a حجة عند جمهور العلماء. It's a proof according to the majority of the scholars, as Ibn al-Qudama mentions in his kitab, روضة الناظر وجنة المناظر. He mentions that in his book. So now let's take the matan of the Shaykh. وتارة sometimes. وتارة من المفهوم. Sometimes we take it from the مفهوم. Are you with me? وهو the مفهوم is. ما دل على الحكم, that which shows the ruling. بمفهوم موافقة. By way, مفهوم موافقة, that's the first type. Are you with me? By way of مفهوم الموافقة, I explain that. إن كان مساويا. So that's مفهوم الموافقة. The first type is called مساويا. So the مفهوم موافقة, the first type of the مفهوم الموافقة is مساويا. It is equal. It is what? What do we call that one? We call it لحن الخطاب, right? Good. فقهاء, they call it, the أصوليين, sorry, they call it لحن الخطاب. أو لا منه, or it's more befitting. What was the example I gave for? إن كان مساوي للمنطوقي. If it's in agreement to the منطوق, what did I give? Yeah? I said, فلا نداز منطوق. تقول ما مفهوم هي. إن الذين يأكلون أموال اليتامى ظلما إنما يأكلون في بطونهم نارا وسيصلون صعيرا. Good. What about أو لا منه? فلا تقل لهما أف. What was the أولى منه الضرب hitting. Very good. Then the Sheikh says, oh, بمفهوم المخالفة, by way of مفهوم المخالفة. And we said how many types of مفهوم المخالفة is. So he's going to explain to you what مفهوم المخالفة is. What is مفهوم المخالفة, also known as دليل الخطاب. دليل الخطاب. أو بمفهوم المخالفة إذا خالف المنطوق. He's explaining to you مفهوم المخالفة. It opposes the منطوق, the utterance. لكن مفهوم الموافقة does not go against the utterance. في حكمه, in its ruling, لكون المنطوق, by way of ruling. How does it differ? One is going to say, if this is permissibility, the opposite is going to say what? Because يَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنْ جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَئٍ فَتَبَيَّنُوا حُرْمَةٍ You're not allowed to take it. You're prohibited from this. The مفهوم المخالفة, by way of sifa here, what does it show? Permissibility of taking it from the one who's reliable, who's not a fasiq. You see, so it differs from it in terms of ruling. لِكَوْنِ الْمَنْطُوقِ وُصِفَ بِوَصْفٍ Because the mantuq, he was connected. The mantuq was connected to a characteristics. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنْ جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ That's the mantuq. The mantuq is a characteristics. أَوْ شُرِطَ Or a condition was attached to the mantuq, which is the ayah what? وَإِنْ كُنَّ أُولَاتِ حَمْلٍ فَأَنْفِقُوا عَلَيْهِنَّ وَإِنْ is connected here. You see, إِذَا تَخَلَّفَ ذَلِكَ الْوَصْفُ أَوِ الشَّرْطِ تَخَلَّفَ الْحُكْمُ If that wasf, description, or that condition is missing, the ruling goes. Meaning, if it's not a fasiq, or she's not pregnant, then the ruling changes. What does it become? The opposite to what the ruling was. And that is what the Shaykh meant.
نعم. وَالدِّلَالَةُ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ ثَلَاثَةُ أَقْسَامِ
Now the author is going to go to, there are dilalah. The way that the kitab and the sunnah, they indicate things are by three ways. They show things by how many ways? By three ways. All of these, brothers, I want you to realize, all of these, they fall under the aqsamul mantuq. They're not mafhum. So these three that we're going to mention, all of them are what? Min aqsamil mantuq. So from the mantuq is divided into three. The mantuq is divided into how many? Three. The mafhum is divided into how many? Two, muwafaqa and mukhalafa. Now the mantuq is divided into three. Hey, what is the first one?
ودلالة مطابقة إذا طبقنا اللفظ على جميع المعنى.
Example, دلالة مطابق means what? For example, the word house. When I say house to you, house means windows, in a roof, doors, knobs, handles, toilet, kitchen. All of that is a house. Is دلالة المطابق. نعم. The second one is what?
ودلالة تضمن إذا استدلنا باللفظ على معناه.
دلالة التضمن is what? If we take a portion of the house, for example, if we say door is a part of the house. The house consists of many doors that come together that make a room. Then the roof has to be on top of it, and etc. So if we take a portion of the house, this is called دلالة التضمن. The third type is called what?
ودلالة التزام إذا استدلنا بلفظ الكتاب والسنة ومعناهما على توابع ذلك ومتمماته وشروطه وما لا يتم ذلك المحكوم فيه أو المخبر عنه إلا به.
This house, if it's got locks, if it's got doors, huh? And it's then it has to have somebody who made it. Dalalatul iltizam means it necessitates from it. That there's no house that's just randomly somewhere unless there's somebody that made it. Now, the Sharia is like that. And I only gave the house as an example so you can understand it. The Sharia is also like that. Our religion is also what? It's like that. That either the word in its all of its meaning. Like for example, the word al-Khaliq, Allah is the creator. The word Khaliq shows us two things. It shows us Allah's existence, and it also shows us the characteristics of creating. So a that and a sifa. A that, an essence, and it also shows us a characteristics of creating. Good. Dalalatul tadammun is what? Dalalatul tadammun is, if we take one of those two, which is either the that, or the characteristics of creating. If I take one of them, it's called dalalatul tadammun. For example, if I say Allah creates and I take one of that. The third one is called dalalatul iltizam. Dalalatul iltizam. Dalalatul iltizam means if Allah is the creator and He did create, then I have to affirm for Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He is what? He's got knowledge. That He has knowledge, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that I also affirm for Him that He has ability. Because no one can create if he doesn't have knowledge and an ability. You have to have the ability to do something, and you also have to have what? Knowledge to know how to do this thing. Or else you can't create, you can't make something. And those three, dalalatul mutabak, dalalatul iltizam, and dalalatul tadammun, you will find it in the nusus al-wahiyya, in the kitab and the sunnah. And Allah mentions that in suratul talaq, the last ayah, Allah says, Allahu alladhi khalaqa sab'a, khalaqa, underline that part. Allahu alladhi khalaqa, He's the one who created. سبع سماوات, seven heavens. ومن الأرض, He created this earth as well. ومن الأرض مثلهن يتنزل الأمر بينهن. His affairs comes down on both of them. سبحانه وتعالى. Why did Allah do that? لتعلموا أن الله على كل شيء قدير. To tell you that Allah is able to do everything. وأن الله قد أحاط بكل شيء علما. And that Allah encompassed everything with knowledge. So Allah telling you, I have ability and I have knowledge. So when I was creating something, I was telling you guys that I have the ability to do things. And I was showing you guys that I have knowledge. Because creating automatically brings with it, and it brings with it what? Ability and knowledge. And based on that, the ulama of fiqh, when they speak about masail like that, one is, they say this is dalalatul mutabaq. Many things fall under it. Dalalatul Tadammun, they take a part out of it. Dalalatul Iltizam is something that necessitates from this. When something necessitates from it, the Shaykh explained it to you, it is either by looking at its mutammimat or its shurut, that which completes it or its conditions. Or, وَمَا لَا يَتِمُّ ذَٰلِكَ الْمَحْكُومِ فِيهِ أَوِ الْمُخْبَرِ عَنُ إِلَّا بِهِ. Or, that thing which is the ruling is being placed on, that it cannot complete, or that which is being spoken about cannot become complete, or its conditions will be met unless this comes in, which is that this house will not have come into existence. It would not have existed if nobody made it. Nah.